Hi, my name is Carrie Thompson, and I'm a lymphoma physician at Mayo Clinic in Rochester. I want to talk about what survivorship care is for our patients with lymphoma. When we treat patients with chemotherapy for their lymphoma, it's a tough time when going through that treatment. There's oftentimes a series of chemotherapy cycles. Oftentimes it's a total of six, and it's a time that can be tough in terms of side effects as well as anxiety regarding the diagnosis and such. But the things that are comforting during that time is the care team, the team of nurses, both in the clinic and the chemotherapy unit, the physicians, the nurse practitioners, the physician's assistants, and generally patients get into a routine where they know what to expect each time. What can be surprising is how challenging it can be when the treatment is done. Generally, it's a time of celebration because that tough time is behind you, but there can be a fair amount of uncertainty of what happens next. That comfortable routine of going in every 3 weeks, having the labs, the visit, the chemotherapy has ended. And what's next? That's where a survivorship visit can be very helpful to ease that transition as well as coordinate care between the lymphoma specialists and primary care providers. What we've done at Mayo in Rochester is set up a visit generally to coincide with that restaging PET scan at the end of treatment. So generally patients will have the PET scan and laboratory studies in the morning, meet with their physician, and then afterwards meet with one of our advanced practice providers to discuss how things have gone over the last six cycles of treatment, what unmet needs there may be, and discuss plans for the future, including symptoms to watch for, who to call and when, what the follow-up visits will be like, including what scans may be done or may not be done, laboratory studies, how frequently those studies will be performed, as well as when to follow up with the primary care provider. In addition, we survey patients with a questionnaire to understand how has the treatment affected people, both from a physical standpoint. We know chemotherapy and sometimes radiation or stem cell transplant can certainly be very challenging, and people can become fairly weak afterwards. So can we help with that? As well as from the psychological standpoint, of course, having a diagnosis of cancer can be very challenging both for the patient and their family. And then the social aspect, both from a job standpoint and financial standpoint, there may be issues that we can help with. Sometimes in the busyness of chemotherapy and going through that routine, those issues get pushed to the side. So this is a nice chance to stop and reflect on how else cancer has affected somebody and what we can do about it. In that appointment, we create what's called a survivorship care plan. This is a brief document, but it's a very important document, which gives the summary of what the patient has had, what's the actual diagnosis, what was the stage of disease, and then spells out the actual treatment that individual has received, including the names of the medications, the chemotherapy drugs, radiation, if that was part of the treatment, including the dose, and if they had a transplant. What that can be really helpful for is care down the road. So we know not everybody stays in one location. Life happens, people move, insurance changes, physicians change over time. But that one document somebody can take with them, and we always provide a copy at that appointment, both to the patient and their primary care provider. So there's always a record of that cancer treatment. In addition, we have written out what to watch for and who to call, as well as potential short-term side effects of treatment, such as chemotherapy-induced neuropathy, and long-term effects that may occur years down the road that are important to watch for, such as side effects of the chemotherapy or radiation to the heart, for example, where we may recommend additional cardiac testing starting 10 years after treatment. It's hard to keep track of all of that if it's not written down. We know that the relationship between patients and physicians is really important, and that's true here with the lymphoma specialists, but also with primary care providers. And that's part of this visit where we really try to coordinate the care and provide a link between us and the physicians who may be here in Rochester, or they may be states away. So that document can really provide that coordination of care. In addition, patients have a lot of questions. This is a time of uncertainty besides, okay, what's next? When will my next visit be? What should I be looking for? But there's also questions about, well, what can I do now to reduce my risk of this lymphoma ever coming back? Or how can I stay healthy now that I've gotten through this? Or how can I get back to health now that I've been through all this treatment and I've become fairly weak? And so a lot of what we do is education regarding what is the latest science that we know about a diet that is most healthy after lymphoma treatment. And exercise. We have a lot of data that physical activity is so important to recovery after lymphoma and may actually reduce the risk of lymphoma coming back. And so we have resources that we can help connect patients with, both here at Mayo with our cardio-oncology rehab program, as well as in patients' local communities, such as the YMCA Live Strong program. So much of what we do during that visit is education, both with written materials, in-person discussion, and we also have a video that we share with every patient at that survivorship visit. So we think the visit's very valuable, but we didn't want to just trust our instincts, so we did a study to determine if that indeed was the case. We asked to see if the visit affected people's overall anxiety levels, because of course, when we're talking about potential effects, both short-term and long-term of chemotherapy and other related cancer treatment, we worry that we may be increasing patients' anxiety. We asked about quality of life, and we also asked about educational needs. Were their needs met, or were there still unanswered questions at the end of treatment? What we found was that quality of life and anxiety were not different between the two groups. And other studies of survivorship visits or survivorship care plans have shown similar results. What we did find was that those who attended the survivorship visit did have improvements in their educational needs being met. So there were less questions about follow-up care and long and short-term side effects of treatment. That indicates better quality of care, which we're really proud of. So now our job is to make sure that all of our patients who are treated with curative intent for lymphoma at Mayo are making their way to a survivorship visit at the end of their treatment.